are new to our channel, my name is Desiree, and today we are going to share 5 tips on how to help you prevent separation anxiety in your new puppy. Usually the anxiety or stress in our dogs is caused by us. That's right, we are the culprit. We love our new puppy, can't stand to see them cry, never want to leave them alone, and don't set any rules and structure. Trust me, I know I am just as guilty. Before we get started, make sure you click that subscribe button to be notified when we post new videos and give us a thumbs up if you're enjoying this topic. Tip number 1, your puppy needs alone time every day. Across the world, many of us are welcoming a brand new puppy or a dog into our home. We have so much free time at home, we want to raise a new puppy. But one thing we may not realize is that even though we are home right now, it is very important to prepare them now for the days ahead when you may not always be home. We want to teach our puppy how to handle short periods of time alone and slowly increase this duration as training progresses. The alone time should be in a controlled environment. This is a perfect opportunity to work on crate training or being in an exercise pen. You can watch the video here on how to crate train your puppy. I know what you're thinking. My puppy cries when I leave them alone. Yes, your puppy is going to cry. This does not mean that your puppy has separation anxiety yet. It usually means that they have not been taught how to self-soothe. Yes, they may cry, but we are going to teach them how to self-soothe and reassure them that with repetition and consistency, we will be back for them. During your puppy's first 8 weeks of life, they would cry for their mother, who would respond to their needs. This is a natural instinct that your pup has. Cry and mom comes running. And this takes me to tip number 2. Do not respond to every cry your puppy makes. It is important that you do not come running back every single time your puppy cries. You will continually reinforce this behavior if you do so. Now, it is time to help your puppy develop into the next stage of their life. Your puppy is going to have to cry it out many times without a response from you before this behavior can change, which takes me to tip number 3. Exercise your puppy. A well-exercised puppy is a well-behaved puppy. Your puppy should always have physical exercise before you're leaving them alone. This could be going on a walk or playing fetch, just spending time exercising your puppy. Your puppy has a lot of energy and you have to provide them a way to get their physical exercise. And this takes me to tip number 4, mental stimulation. Your puppy not only needs physical exercise, they also need mental stimulation. This could be a treat stuffed Kong or other enrichment games to help keep your puppy busy. If your puppy has a positive association between being left alone and good things, they are less likely to develop separation anxiety. You can stuff a Kong with a variety of wet and dry ingredients to create a challenge which typically will last 20 minutes. This keeps your dog busy during a time when anxiety levels can be at its peak. A Kong can even be frozen so that it'll take even longer for them to enjoy. If you would like to see a video on enrichment game ideas, let us know in the comments below. And this brings me to tip number 5 to help you prevent separation anxiety in your puppy. It is consistency and patience. If you are consistent with these tips, some patience, and a lot of repetition, you can build your puppy's confidence and avoid separation anxiety. If you want to learn more about crate training your puppy, click the video over here. And if you want to prepare for bringing home a new puppy, then click the video over here. Until next time, bye!